chasing status.
Well, then, motorcycle fans, how's everyone doing on this sunny Sunday afternoon, 31st of October? So, we've been to a sports bike shop this morning, absolutely howling rain, sideways rain, wind, cold, horrible. So I went in the car, and then on the way back, it was all bright sunshine, so we thought, okay, we'll dig the bikes out for a quick spin. Anna's bought some new jeans and some new boots from last week from Moto Central, and she's just trying those out. So what's the make of jeans, Anna? Resurgence, and they came highly recommended from Lord Hepcat. So we're down at Moto Central, rode down with him last Saturday, watched that thing in the road, and that was a really nice day out, and the rain managed to keep up, so she bought these Resurgent jeans, so I thought, well, I'll have some of those, so I've ordered some. And just going to try them on this morning, and the label which says 12 looks like somebody's glued the little 12 tag over the what should be 10, so they're going back. So Anna's bought some armour for us from the sports bike shop. She's ordered some cruiser gloves as well. And one or two little bits and bobs. I've got some boots. I've got some Star Martin cruiser boots, which I haven't got on today because they don't go with the girl pants, moto girl pants. So I'll wait for the Resurgence jeans to come through and then I can wear them. The forecast for next week is, though it's dry, it's going to drop to 2-3 degrees. So, local council last year, anything over or under 5, they salted the road. So, this could be the last time out for a week or two. And obviously, it's getting colder and lousier and all the rest of it. So just going to get some fuel. Sun's blinding. Right. God, this brake's terrible on this thing. Until you warm it up. Sintered brake pads, no less. So yeah, these are new waterproof gloves. These are Revit. My old waterproof gloves, which are Alpine Stars, I found out when I did the North Coast 500, they're anything but waterproof. So the only real waterproof gloves I've got are heated ones. They're a bit clumpy. I don't like, you know, not being able to feel the bars in them, but so I'm just trying to find me money. Yeah. Anna's new gloves, motorcycle fan. She got those from Moto Central last week. She spent a small fortune, and I did today at a sports bike shop, but hey ho. Because what? You got lots there. Don't. Just poke it. It's going to go outside your helmet anyway. I think a crew cut, really, that would suit you, wouldn't it? Could do with grips. Yeah, we tried putting speakers in them, and there's not really enough room in this. Basically, it's a Bell Bullet clone. It's by Viper. Fiberglass shell, £150. I mean, it's a great helmet. It's lovely, nice lined. But there's not real room for intercom speakers, so she's got little earbuds, pods. We call them earbuds, but there we go. So, same as the off-road helmets, they can't really take speakers very well, so we do the same thing, just have little headphones in. Right, we're ready. No Wolfie sitting on the bank. So yes, Motorcycle Fans, had a really nice time last week riding with Ian. That's the first time we've ridden with him for a couple of years, I think. He was out on his lovely MT10. What a machine that is. Oof, crikey. He very kindly let us both have a go on it, and wow, yeah, that is one hell of a machine. Fast, comfortable, responsive. Yeah, he's got a good one there. So I thought when he sold his FJR, oh Ian, you know, that was a great tourer, but I think this one's going to be even better. And for spirited riding, it's going to be great on the bendy bits as well. So. So anyway, that's just a little update, Motorcycle Fans, and I'll talk to you in another one. You take care. Bye-bye.